Hello, Mr. Nygren here. So I'm back. I just ate breakfast. So the clock is 8:00 Swedish time in the morning. I've been playing for about 3 or so hours already. I might be wrong, but I've played for a couple of hours. Alright, so Stettin is once again being attacked by the USSR, also known as the United Soviet Socialist Republics, referred to as the Soviet Union. In this model, they are known as, they are named USSR, but we will say Soviet Union, the most common name. Okay, so the Soviet Union is attacking Stettin, and if Stettin falls, Berlin is next, but Berlin is heavily defended. Okay, so we'll fight the Battle of Stettin. The reinforcing plane unit will be AI controlled. To be, yeah, I know that I said. Okay, AI controlled and start the battle. So we only have Messerschmitt 109 fighters in the city, and then another one outside. So an entire army of planes plus the general. I think we'll win this. We had the upper hand in the balance of power status deck. Okay.
Für das Reich. Die Feinde des Reiches werden nicht entkommen.
The Siegfried Line Wall. The best wall. The bunkers. And we have the army here. We can move the general to the center of the city. Don't need him at the front. We will also place him at loose formation and place him at the center and use guard mode. Then we will group the planes and place them in loose formation. Didn't work for some reason. Let's group them and guard mode and AI control. And then we will take a look at the enemy, the attacking army. So we have some jeeps here, jeep bodyguards, lots of planes. It's a plane army. And they have some T-34-85s, equal in power to the Tiger ones. Okay, let's start the battle. Have some planes here at the outskirts as well. Fight immediately. Our bunkers took out some of their T-34-85 tanks. Yeah, we took out all of them. Now it's a battle between the Air Force. Air Forces. General is at the center. Reinforcements, yeah, we got the reinforcement army too. Should arrive here. I think this is it. Maybe it's not arrived yet. It should be the battle. Captured was the final one. Let's fast forward, otherwise it will take forever. Battles in the sky will take forever if you don't use fast forward. Planes, one should just order them to attack and then let the AI do the rest. What the fuck? They have taken the the city center. They killed our general and took the center. Every plane moved to the center immediately. What the fuck, man? We are almost losing. Peace. So our planes are back in center. So we lost the general Alexander. An enemy general for Alexander Isakon, so they lost their general. Building captured. Building lost the center. We still have our general. But for some reason he moved out of the plaza. I don't know where he is. He moved here for some reason. Right, so he's fighting. Let's just keep him there. As long as our planes are holding the center, we are fine. I don't like when the enemy wins by the timer. Let's remove this use in the lower left corner here. Look at that. Sky. Okay. Yeah, they are clearly winning this one. Lots of planes. They're partaking in this gold fight. Balance of power. 10% allies killed, 42% enemies killed. There's some enemy planes outside, but they are also fighting, so we'll win soon. We had too many planes for them. Here they have another one. Our planes are also superior than theirs in stats. They usually have the numerical advantage. This time they didn't, so they couldn't do it. Question is if they will attack again. Lost no unit at least. We lost a few planes in the units. They were 24 to start. Maybe not all, but most. Here we have another one, the Soviet plane.
Keiner kann bestreiten.
And it's over. Clear victory! Your army is under Hans Busch and Captain Richard. So Hans Busch's army had 387 planes, killed 160. Where we had a jeep bodyguard too. Killed 160, had 334 remaining. Enemy army under Alexander Isakov, who died in battle, had 313 men, lost killed 48, and have 153 remaining. Alright, and the battle stat sticks, and the battle's over. Stettin was properly defended once again. That was the third or fourth battle of Stettin. The first in a while. They didn't attack immediately. Good. They are focusing on retaking the rebel area here of Prague. I believe they want to take that area. They move the General Igor Voroshilo there. They have other armies outside here, Captain Levitt Plains and Clement Vatutin with another full army. They will attack Munichen again soon. Let's merge our infantry. Right, we'll merge all of them. And try that, it didn't work. So, now it worked. Okay, we don't need 13. Let's disband. So we have room for 8 more units here. So we'll move 8 infantry units there. Actually, so that's 8 infantry units. Good. Not that they matter much, but they will be prepared to fight this army the next time. The next turn. We could merge these troops as well. No point not merging infantry. One should never merge planes in this mod. Okay. This man, disband that unit, only 15 remaining. At 70. No, it doesn't work. 40 is their full size. 80. Okay, we can move 2 other units there. Let's move this rifleman unit there. Any assault infantry there. So in Berlin, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Move that unit out to the army. Move this unit Berlin itself. This unit could be moved to the army as well. We could use one of these bigger planes in the army too. So this is the army of Gunther Alterbung. Said wrongly that the army in München was led by him. It's led by Paul von Manstein. Okay, end of turn report. We are plus 8013 in profits, that's good. Faction announcement. Don't matter. Don't care. Construction complete. We have an aerodrome in München. So now we can do the U8, we can construct the U88 in München as well. That's good. And then we have some new recruitment. In Berlin we have U88, in Frankfurt we have U88, we just moved those. Staten, we had a Messerschmitt, 109 fighter, same in München, same in Hamburg. We have Assault Infantry in Copenhagen, more Messerschmitts in Rouen, and U88 in Amsterdam and Paris. Okay. Diplomatic information. The following factions have broken their alliances. British Commonwealth of Nations, also known as the British Empire, has broken their alliance with the United Soviet Socialist Republics, also known as the Soviet Union. Portugal has broken their alliance with the French Republic and with the United States. That's good. Following factions have declared a ceasefire. French Republic and the Italian Empire and the United States of America, French State, Vichy and French Republic. Alright, so this could mean that Britain and the United Soviet Socialist Republics, also known as the Soviet Union, might have started a war against each other here in Turkey. They border each other here. So if we're lucky, they will start to fight each other. Soviets will move down here into the Middle East and fight the French and the British. Or the British will move up and take the rest of Turkey and maybe move up here. In, I believe, is this Kazakhstan, maybe? I don't know. Georgia, Armenia, Kazakhstan. Something like that. Anyway. I don't know. But I think Armenia is somewhere here. Okay. Italian Empire still holding Istanbul. Preventing the British from coming this way. And Belgrade has revolted and is no longer held by the Soviet Union. Okay. Can move this spy down here. Vienne. What? Vienne is ours again. Vienne has revolted to the German Reich. Germans in Vienne revolted. So we have assault infantry here and we have riflemen. They will probably retake that city soon because it's surrounded by Soviet troops. T-34-85's outside. I didn't know that we got that city back. I wonder if it happened now or if it happened the previous turn. They will attack München and they will attack Vienne for sure.
Kaiser.
Can't really reinforce the area either.
Kaiser.
Let's move another rifleman unit down to München.
Kaiser.
Alright, that's it. Now Frankfurt is weakened. We have a Spanish plane unit here too.
Kaiser.
Okay, let's move rifleman unit to Frankfurt. Move in this U88 into Paris. Portugal had two of those. As for that unit, we could probably defend quite well there. We'll move another plane to Frankfurt. It's too important, we can't let it fall. We have Brussels here. Most of these can be moved to Frankfurt. Submerge the troops as well.
Kaiser.
We haven't done so in a while. This was the army that retook Brussels after all, so they are damaged. Frankfurt, sure. Emerge. And we have a general in Amsterdam.
Kaiser.
Move some assault infantry down to Frankfurt as well. And these troops. Good. Almost a full army.
Okay.
Two more units could be added there. Let's move this unit down to Hamburg.
And
we need planes in each city in case that Spanish plane unit will attack. You don't really need a rifleman there anymore. But I don't want the yellow guy to face to be red, so we'll keep the infantry there too. So we have planes here, but we lost a few. They will show us, but to move some new planes to Stettin. To make up for the losses. We lost three units in the previous battle, plus all units are probably damaged too. We will have to do with these reinforcements. Here we have an army. Under Sergei Ivanov, marching up towards Berlin or something. Okay. Alright, so that's the situation. The Soviet Union has had a couple of revolts in Prague and Elba, Lula, and in Belgrade. I expect the Spanish state to do a suicidal attack somewhere. And München will be attacked, as well as Vienna. So the town could destroy the small concern to prevent the Soviet Union from having that building. As for this settlement, I believe we can fight the battle. It's not certain we will lose it, we will not destroy it. Okay. Could speak to someone with our diplomat. United Soviet Socialist Republic. We'll speak to the Soviet Union.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create
map
a proposal.
Information.
Left click on an
thank
item
you.
In the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous.
Something changed in Asia. I believe the Japanese became more visible. They're holding a settlement here, known as Harbin. Otherwise it looks the same. They hope they will start a war, the Soviet Union, with the British. Okay. So they have a few revolts to handle. The Union. So our diplomat could also speak with the Italian Empire again.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty.
Get the updated information. This is still counted as enemy, probably Britain or France. Okay, we need to see that we have constructed and built stuff too. Okay, in Berlin we are still constructing the airport. In München we can go for the large caserne or for the howitzer training ground. We'll go for the howitzer training ground. It will allow us to get the Vesp and then the aircraft truck, etc. And I believe in most other areas we are constructing stuff already. In Vienna we can get the small concern, but I destroyed it just to prevent the Soviets from getting it, so we won't build a new one. Now the recruitment in Berlin. We'll go for another U-88 twin engine, multiple... what was the... multiple combat aircraft. Okay. We'll go for that trooper in Oslo. U-88 in München now as well, of course. We'll go for that one. And Messerschmitt 109s in Hamburg. U-88s in Frankfurt. So most of our cities can now build the U-88 twin engine multiple combat aircraft. Same in Amsterdam and... Yeah, and in Paris, that's very good. And to get something new instead of the old Messerschmitts everywhere like before. And assault infantry in Copenhagen. We're back in Berlin. Alright, next turn. Ah, they attacked Vienne, as expected. Take a look at their army. 3 units of planes. We have another troop there. Infantry and tanks, and then an army. We will just auto-resolve this. We can't win. They didn't attack anywhere else. That was surprising. They have rebels to handle. They took back Vienne from the revolting Germans. And they've also reconquered Alba Iulia from the rebels. They are besieging Belgrade, another area that revolted. There are Vichy French in our area. There are Jarlum Catrock's faction air. He has an officer's car bodyguard. Looks like that. Alright. The Soviet army here too outside. Under Igor Voroshilov. Soviet general. And the Spanish state is preparing to attack Brussels again. It's 1 unit of planes. We have 2, so we could probably win. We have 2 full units of fully sized units of planes, Messerschmitt planes. They took back Vienna, the Soviet Union. Settlement occupied Vienna. Yes, agent detected Portugal. Okay. End of turn report. We are plus 2,168 in profits. Construction report. In Stettin we have upgraded Stettin to a city, and Rouen has also been upgraded to a city. So we have city now in Rouen, and Stettin too has been upgraded. It's a bigger settlement. Recruitment report. In Copenhagen we have assault infantry, in Oslo we have trooper ships, and in Brussels we have a Messerschmitt 109 fighter unit ready. I forgot to check the diplomatic staff. I managed to click it. I managed to exit that tab instead of looking at it. So the Soviet Union wants to take back Prague from the rebels. That's why they didn't attack me. AI prioritizes taking care of rebels. Okay. So Stettin has been upgraded. That means we can get new buildings. Of course we should already have a few things, like for example medium park, the farms plus 2, the asphalt roads, SS headquarters, and yeah, those are the ones we should have. Fuck, different build, different buttons when it's room to lower, I forgot. So a different button to bring up the console command window. CQ, process CQ. Stettin. Good. And now we have all of that built in Stettin. As for the rest, we'll go for the aerodromes. We can get the U-88s from Stettin as well. So we'll go for that. And we're still constructing Messerschmitts in Stettin. And the other area that was upgraded, Brussels. No, Rouen, I think. So they will have farms plus 2, they will have asphalt roads, SS headquarters, and the medium park. Large caserne, medium tank, factory, howitzer, training ground, shipwright, aerodrome. No, none of those. Go for all the civilian building. It's buildings. It's 1944, so they should be available. Okay, because it's more fun to fight the battles in real time if we have all that stuff in the settlement as well. Okay, so we have the civilian buildings. I believe we also upgraded München recently. No, we didn't. construction complete. We have a medium park instead. Construction complete. We have farms plus two. And we have asphalt roads. We have the SS headquarters. Then in Raven we have farms plus two. Asphalt roads. SS headquarters. And the medium park. So same buildings in both of those areas. And the British are blockading our port in Raven. With one unit of ships. So we have asphalt roads everywhere here now. The Spanish have three more units here. And they've taken Lyon from the Vichy French. Capital of Vichy France has fallen. But French state Vichy is still around. They have some Renault FT tanks. Scout snipers, and their units are unique. They are the same as the Free French, but they are not clones of anyone else. You can say both the French factions, Frère, Infantry and such, but they have different textures. Okay. What about this area? It's still an allied area, Marseille. Okay, but their capital has fallen to the Spanish state. That means the Spanish state can attack Paris next. Actually, the army headquarters, we should already have that, but I will wait one turn for the heavy tank factory to be completed. Then we will build this automatically and no, we won't, because this is Paris. It would take time for them to build the buildings in Paris. Well, in actual German areas, it's a different matter. Of course, in things like the Medium Park and such, it would be easy to set up. Maybe we'll build the army headquarters too. It's a civilian building. It will only enable us to get spies. It's not a military building anyway. It's 1944, so. Okay, so the Soviet Union still about to take that city. They've taken Sofia from the Italians. I didn't see that. So they've taken another area from Italy. So Italy is losing their areas here in the Balkans and in Greece. Or at least the Soviet Union has taken Romania. And one area that used to belong to Bulgaria. And are about to storm the rebels in Yugoslavia. Okay, so I think we probably already did the construction and stuff, but I will check just to be sure. So in the next turn we will finish a lot of buildings. In Rouen, we can get something new. I think we will go for the aerodrome, so we can get U-88 twin-engine combat aircraft there as well. And that's it. And then recruitment. In Brussels, we'll get some Messerschmitt 109 fighters. And assault infantry as usual in Copenhagen. And that's it. Next time. The Soviet Union finally attacked again. We are an ally now, the Vichy French. Only their leader, or heir, will partake in the battle. French jeep partaking the Battle of München. And we have a new unit of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes, unless that's a U-88 unit. Might be. Can't see. And then we have this army, mostly infantry and the remnant Messerschmitt 109 fighters, and the General Paul von Manstein. Manstein. Igor Voroshilov is the Russian general. He has a bodyguard of officers, armored officers' car. He has lots of planes, MiG-3s and Yak-9 planes, fighter planes. And he has the MERS tank, the MS-1, and the T-34-85, really good tank, and some infantry. Let's save. We'll see if Minchen will fall this time. This is the first battle where we have an ally fighting with us, the French. Vichy French. Right.
Die Zeit ist gekommen, Männer.
This is a city.
Kaiser stolz. Ihnen nach, Männer, für das Reich.
We had the worst wall, but that's the not the worst in gameplay. It's the worst. It's ranked as the worst wall. It has machine gun towers, but it's way better than that brick wall. Where all the units get stuck all the time. Okay, so we have force here. A lot of infantry as usual. General's jeep, bodyguard, armored officer's car, bodyguard. We have the planes, the Messerschmitt 109 fighters. They have been in battle already. We might be at a disadvantage there. The enemy army has lots of planes, so they have a clear advantage in the air. That's why they might win. They also have an armored officer's car. And they had some tanks, including these beasts. Improved T-34s with 85 cannons, millimeter cannons. 85 millimeter cannons. And then they had some worse tanks too. The MS-1 light tanks somewhere. Where they are. Here is one without a turret. Here are three with turrets. Okay. About our army. We will place the general over here. Loose formation. Guard this area. As for the rest, loose formation. Group them all and then AI control and guard mode. Start the battle. Reinforcements are arriving. A reinforcement is a unit of U-88s. I hope they will enter the battle. Who they are. So we had a really good plane reinforcing us this time. I hope they won't get stuck or something. Then we have the French ally, the armored officer's car of the air, the Vichy French. Here's their air. They have machine guns as usual. Will probably be defeated. They are on equal strength to a BB motorcycle. Battle has started. Their tanks here, they entered with some T-34-85s that they moved out again because they faced heavy fire. Mountain planes, towers, machine gun towers. And lots of infantry here too. Defending. This is not the best tank of the Soviet Union. It's the second best. They have another one that is even better. It hasn't yet arrived on the battlefield. What is happening over here? They seem to have entered. One of them is still stuck. I hope they will not stand there forever and actually move. Should probably have controlled that unit myself. Couldn't control the French, but they will certainly reach the battlefield. Maybe not, they might just stand there. They are moving now. Now this decided to stand here. They will probably reach the enemy and be defeated. These guys, I'm afraid, might get stuck. Then I might need to reload the game. That's not what I wanted. So they might not even be part of the battle. I forgot that they can get stuck. Some infantry have exited the city. Bigger than before. This is the aerodrome. We haven't seen it before. It's larger than the airstrip. There's fighters there. More than one or two. It has some anti-air stuff too. So this is the aerodrome. I really dislike that my plane was stuck. They are moving, finally. But they might actually not move from this spot. Fuck, I could load, but then all the tanks will get turret fired again. Turret fired. So I don't know about that. I wasted that unit. Planes at the center. Our bodyguard is still around, defending. You can hear the machine gun fire. Yeah. Taking out a few of the jeeps though. One of the planes back to the center. So our general is defeated. Actually, we might need to move more of them back. Try to move all of them back to the center. Around. So, great number stuck here for some reason.
Gott schütze uns! Unser General liegt tot auf dem Schlachtfeld. Ohne ihn könnten seine Männer den Mut und die Schlacht verlieren.
Manstein died. Lost the general. planes finally reach the center. That's good. Move to the center. This means so they can't be in by the timer. I don't like when that happens. If they win, they should always kill every soldier first. Okay, or break them. They had lots of infantry outside. Didn't see that at first. The French sheep should be arriving at the battlefield now. Center. Most of our jeeps are dead too, including the general. All the jeeps are dead. Actually, we need to move in the planes, otherwise, we will lose.
General wurde erschlagen. Rächt ihn.
Our ally might be defeated soon. French ally. They are still fighting. Our planes have probably arrived here. Aid them. Center. One of the riflemen here. Managed to do that. All of them are coming. They are all broken. Is there planes that fire at them? Here is one unit that is broken. Maybe it is. And lots of infantry. We need them at the center. They're gonna die. They will die there. huge numbers of riflemen. Still have some planes in the air here too. Fighting their planes. What's happening over here? The French general is in trouble. They lost all of their jeeps, with the exception of the one the general, and it will soon die. So we shot down. Oh, he died. Jerome Catrox, the heir of Richie France, died. Soviet Union sent in their MS-1s against them. What about the air battle? Where is our U-88 bombers? Taking down one here. I remember that they were weaker than the Portuguese Wellington planes. Not good. Battle at center is still going on. Here comes the infantry. They are already broken, despite their numbers. When they break, they automatically will move towards the city center anyway. You lost all the planes. We just need to move all the infantry to the center for a final stand. They're being fired at as they march towards the center, or flee in panic towards the center. This is the battle that sticks. 49% allies killed, 51% allies killed, 44% enemies killed, 52% allies killed. Defeat seems certain, only a military genius could win. Shit, we lost. We didn't reach the center in time, so we lost the battle. They would all be slaughtered at the center anyway. Soviet Union won thanks to their miracle advantage in planes. Alright, we lost the battle. Paul von Manstein had 904 men, killed 227. And... have 396 remaining, but all of them will die now because this was a city battle. Captain Wolf had 25 of the new U-88 twin engine multiple combat aircraft and still only killed 3 and lost the unit. Jerome Catrox had 41 Jeep's bodyguard, full unit of Jeep's bodyguard and or armored officer's car, and 13 remaining. The enemy, Igor Varoshilov of the Soviet Union, had 541 men, killed 546 and 323 remaining. So the only one that did well was the Soviet Union in this battle. Okay, and here are the detailed statistics. And München has been lost to the Soviet Union. Not good. One of the areas where it could use could build that U-88 twin engine. Multiple aircraft, but multiple combat aircraft, but unfortunately it wasn't as good as the Wellington. The Wellingtons were actually superior to other fighters, while the U-88 was kind of meh. I think they need the same stats as the Wellington, or at least better stats. So we lost München. Settlement occupied. München, yes. End of turn report, we are minus 20,822. Faction announcements, Heroes Death, Paul von Manstein, and Retinue Expanse, Paul Kremer and Reinhold Ostmann. Construction report, in Amsterdam we have a large city completed, and in Paris we have a heavy tank factory completed. Recruitment report, Berlin, we have the new U-88, twin engine multiple aircraft, combat aircraft. Same in Frankfurt, Stettin and München, but we lost the one in München in the battle. Hamburg has a new Messerschmitt 109 fighter, we have new SLT infantry in Copenhagen, we have another Messerschmitt 109 fighter in Rouen, and U-88 multiple combat aircraft in Amsterdam and Paris as well. Diplomatic information: the following factions have declared a ceasefire: the Italian Empire and the United States of America, the French State Vichy and the United Soviet Socialist Republics, or USSR. Okay. Spanish state is about to invade, I believe. We have a full army here under their leader Adolfo Squarcia. I believe in Spanish that means Adolf. So Adolf Socha. Funny. Anyway, in real history, their leader was named Franco. Here is now named Adolfo Socha. Okay. We have another twin engine bomber. We can move the riflemen to Rouen. The plane into Paris. Move another unit there. Plane to Paris. Spain is about to attack Brussels again. With two planes there. Three, four units there. Really need one in Rouen. Brussels. So we can construct planes there. Here we can also construct planes, but we are constructing the aerodrome. I think the area of Rouen is more important than Brussels. But Paris is the most important. We won't be able to defend against that huge arm anyway, they will probably take Rouen the next turn. This area will fall as well. Let's move another plane there to fight them. Reinhold will also be moved to Brussels. Okay, Frankfurt has some troops there too. Move a unit. Let's see. There are two units of those heavies. Move a unit of tactical bombers. Amsterdam. And another unit of U-88 to Frankfurt. Soviet armies outside of Berlin. Another Messerschmitt outside to that army outside of Berlin. Okay. Oh, Verona has fallen to the Soviet Union. They've taken that from Italy. They've also taken Zagreb from Italy. And Belgrade is still a rebel settlement. That means the Italian Empire is no longer united. And the British have finally reached this area of the continent. They have reached Istanbul. But it's not under siege. Alright, I need to go do some errands. See you soon. Hello, Mr. Nygren here. So I'm back. I had to go do some private businesses, but now I'm back. So we are continuing the campaign in Total War 1942. I'm playing as the German Reich, or the Third Reich in this mode, but the real name was the German Reich, which simply means the Anyway, so the British have finally started to attack the Italian Empire. They haven't started to besiege the city of Istanbul yet, but they are outside and preparing to invade. They have a full army under William Davis, family member. An armored officer's car here. This is the first time the British have reached mainland Europe. They didn't come by ship, despite having total naval superiority. Their ships are mostly sinking our ships and then blockading the ports, but haven't done much more. They haven't moved any troops. So, but they did, they or the French did take this area. It states Turkey, but Turkey is destroyed. So. Anyway, they will probably invade Istanbul soon. Equal numbers, but no, the British are superior. They have Spitfires. Can't really see their statistics there. So experience 1, they have 26 missile attack and 24 total defense. Okay, that's all we can see of the British army currently.
Yeah,
and move this spy closer. French state witch diplomat here as well. Don't want to click on the enemy or ally. Want to move the spy closer. Now you can see more. They have another general here too, Ian Anderson, family member. Also has the same bodyguard, armored officer, car bodyguard. They have some tanks, Matilda tank. This version of Total War 1942. Doesn't have the new heavy tank and the medium tank. It only has the light tank, Matilda. The Matilda light tank and the... It has the Churchill heavy tank, but it doesn't have the super heavy later tank of the British, and it doesn't have the medium tank either. Okay, they have some scout snipers too. British scout snipers. Can't see anything else.
No,
maybe I can. Yes, they have two Matilda light tanks. They have a lot of Spitfire planes. They have the scout snipers and two armored officers' car. They are ready to take Istanbul from the Italian Empire, which will give the British a region in the Balkans and Greece. Okay. The Soviet Union will probably take Belgrade the next turn. They retook Prague from the rebels and then attacked the Italians. They have taken one area, Verona, from Italy. Spanish state will attack Brussels and Rouen, I'm pretty sure of that. We have Soviet troops preparing to invade here too. Two large armies. We will be able to defend against one of them, but if they attack with the other immediately, then we might actually lose that. So we'll see.
Kaiser.
We have a plane unit here. Let's move it to the army. Okay. What about the other areas? Frankfurt, Hamburg. Could use a fighter plane in Amsterdam, but I believe Brussels is about to be attacked. So we'll move another plane there.
Kaiser, Kaiser.
We need a plane in Hamburg to move the infantry to Amsterdam. Okay. Need a plane there too. If I don't have a plane in Hamburg, they might actually attack that instead. Let's move two units of assault infantry to Hamburg. Move these ships. There's ships outside of Oslo. We have nothing to move there anyway. Okay, we'll defend in Stettin. Spain is gonna attack us in Rouen or Brussels or both. Soviet Union, they will attack at Stettin. Problem is, they will probably attack Frankfurt too. Actually, we will move this plane down to Frankfurt to defend. We don't need one in Hamburg.
Mein Kaiser? Mein Kaiser?
Actually, we could use
ja, mein Kaiser.
A plane there after all. We moved one from the army to Hamburg. Or air is there after all, Erwin Roman. Okay. Let's check the construction and recruitment. So we need to wait 2 turns until we have the airport. And then it will take at the minimum 2 turns to construct the MiG-262 as well. So it's at least 4 turns away, maybe more. Here we need to wait 1 turn for the airport at Frankfurt. I hope it won't be taken anytime soon. In Amsterdam. Yeah, that's the city that was upgraded. We need to use the sheet. Not to build that, but we need the farms. +3. The big park. Army headquarters. And that's it, I believe. Amsterdam. Amsterdam. I wrote the wrong thing. It should be process seek. What? Process seek. So we have a farms +3 in Amsterdam. And we have the big park, and we have the army headquarters. Alright, we need to check again. So we get to Amsterdam. So we are in Amsterdam now. We'll get the airport at Amsterdam, so we can get the U-88 bombers there too. And in Paris, could actually get the army headquarters. Forgot space there. Okay, so now we have it, and we will build the airport so we can get the U-88s there too. And we're back in Berlin. We don't have a lot of areas anymore. And how many turns will it take to reconstruct? 2 turns. And 2 turns left until that construction is completed. So yeah, we will go for another EU-88, I believe. No, we could actually go for the we will go for the U-88 in Berlin. Trooper in Oslo. Messerschmitt 109 in Hamburg. In Frankfurt. 1 turn left. So you can't go for anything that takes more than 1 turn to recruit. 2 turns. Let's go for the Vesp artillery unit then. No, we will go for the BMW motorcycle in Frankfurt. Amsterdam. Go for U-88 heavy bombers there. Or multiple aircraft, combat aircraft bombers. Okay, and Paris U-88. Rowan will go for the Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Stettin will also go for the Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Assault infantry in Copenhagen as usual. We're back in Berlin. Ok. army headquarters in Paris. I'm interested to see what the British are up to. They have the General Brian Wavell family member here too. Okay. Actually, we could use the diplomat, I guess, and speak to some people.
Yeah.
Let's speak to the Soviet Union to get updated map information.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Some stuff happened.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal.
All right. Could probably speak to the British now as well. We will do that. It's been a long time since we did.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Map information with the British will be good.
To remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
They took some areas in Africa from the Italian Empire. They've taken this area, Mogadishu, from the Italian Empire. And Addis Ababa is also held by them now. And they are holding these areas as I knew they had. They were... What about Asia? They're holding some areas in Asia here. Former Thailand areas. Thailandish areas. Okay. French state, we could use updated information there too.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty.
And we can speak to the Italian Empire.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal.
Map information.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very
zoom in on the map so we can see something. Okay, Soviet Union is huge as we knew. Italian Empire has lost a lot of areas to them. Now the British are upon them as well. If the British take this area, then the Soviet Union will be able to move their fleet out because they are allied to the British, I think. Let's check that. Diplomacy. We are allied to the Japanese Empire and to the French state still. So the British Commonwealth of Nations, no, they are no longer allied to the Soviets, so it won't help. They will still be landlocked here. But it might force them into declaring war against the British. Which will be good. The Italians are too weak to stop the Soviets, but the British might be able to, if we're lucky. Okay. I guess it's time to click next turn. Yeah, they attacked Stettin again. Two armies. They attacked it once with both of them. We might lose this battle. They have numerical advantage in the air. We have an army of planes, but most of them are weakened since the last battle. They didn't have a general here. They have two units of T-34s. Actually, one unit of T-34-85 and two units of T-34s. Lots of MiG trees and some infantry. And then they had an army of mostly infantry and some more planes and tanks. Okay, save the game. Fight the battle on the battle map. Our general is Hans Busch. Alright, fight the battle on the battle map.
Für das Reich. Die Feinde des Reiches werden nicht entkommen.
Alright, so Dagovac Sirianis just wrote to me on Discord and said that I just need to replace a model of the wall to get the new brick wall. So I will do that after exiting this game. Then I will get the new brick wall in this version, which means the gate will no longer cause trouble for tanks and other units to move in and out when that wall is used. Unfortunately, most of the walls now will not have that wall anyway, but if there are any areas with that wall still, then that will be fixed. So I will do that when I exit the game, but I won't exit until I tire. So we'll continue to fight this version for now, and then when I exit it I will replace that file, and then we will have the better wall. And it will be compatible with the saves, because the text is already there, we just replaced the model. Okay, there are a lot of planes here. Let's move all of them here. And group them. Loose formation, guard mode. And the general's bodyguard should also be loose formation and placed at the center. AI control for the planes. Start the battle. So Hans Busch will be fighting the Battle of Stettin. The two armies are on the other side. Here we have an army. Lots of planes there. They have infantry, etc. Moving forward some of their units, but most are standing still. Now they start to move everything. Including tanks, and this one tank, this was the weaker force. And then on the other side, we have more planes, the real army. The heavy tanks. We have the siege free wall. We'll take out some of their tanks, but some of them will enter. And with some T-34s here, and the T-34-85s. And lots of planes. The battle is starting. They're going straight to the center. And from the other side this time. We had most of the planes in the center now. So I didn't want them to take the center. Through the timers, I placed them there to prevent that.
Unsere Mauern wurden eingenommen.
Alright, building lost, but that will change fast. They are moving all their infantry around the city. Lots of infantry in the second army. Alright, their planes are fighting now. Dog fight has started. Balance of power is very balanced. Balance of forces is evenly matched. 7% enemies killed, 0% allies killed. Good. Okay, so we'll see if the infantry will enter. They need to go around the city. This is an invisible wall, I guess. Outside, needing to go all the way around. invisible obstacle here. Battles are on time. Yeah, I can see the time. 40 minutes. Let's fast forward. Takes forever. Infantry is about to enter. They are entering. Defensive battles, I just placed them at AI control and under AI control and laid out the battle. No, it's not much of a strategic battle. The balance of power, 17% allies killed, 4% enemies killed. We are winning this battle. We still managed to win. That's good. All their infantry have been killed or routed. Most of them. There are some more infantry.
Unser schwachköpfiger General hat sein Leben weggeworfen. Und vielleicht unsere Chance auf Sieg gleich mit.
Your planes. Heroic death. Hans Busch died. He lost the general. Faster than have speed, fast speed. Bunker took out a lot of their infantry and they were routing too. Fighters we can defend, but we can't really do much more. They have so many areas now that they can just attack and attack and attack and play with. That's why we need better stuff. And the UA-88 twin engine multiple combat aircraft are not good enough. If they were as good as the Wellington bombers, then yes. But they are weaker. 3% ally scale, the 1%. Enemies. Dead balance of forces is still evenly matched. 6% allies killed, 57, 2% enemies killed. They have started to take out our planes without losing much. We'd still lose. Balance of power is shifting to their advantage. Captain Gregoria of the USSR. Lost more than half the army. Okay, and they are still at 72%. Killed. Close victory! Timer went down just in time. We would have lost otherwise, because they only lost 1% the last few minutes and we lost a lot. So they would have won if the battle had continued. Close victory. Hans Busch died. He had 244 men, his bodyguard, and then the planes. Killed 929, that was very good. A lot of those units killed were infantry as well. Men remaining 85, and Captain Gregorio had 449 men, killed 146 for planes, 194 remaining. That was good too. Captain Clement had 825, killed 20 of our planes. And the detailed statistics. Return to the map. Crash, good. They didn't attack immediately. Stettin was saved. It was just luck. We have almost nothing in Stettin. Two plane units, that's nothing. Actually, this army inside of Stettin. Altbung's army, family member. Lot of tanks there, but also planes and a general. Had no choice now. We want to keep that settlement, we had to move the army there. Most of the tanks are full sized, so only two units might be actually without turrets. let's do this. And we have room for another unit as well. Move that plane unit to Stettin. The infantry to Hamburg. Now we have a unit, an army of infantry, of only assault infantry, in the in the north of Berlin. Another one in the east of Berlin. Then we have the elite infantry unit or army with SS units and snipers and assault infantry in the south of Berlin. And we have nothing to the east of Berlin. Berlin has a strong army of planes. Okay, lots of planes there. We could use another army defending Kaiser. Berlin.
Ja, Kaiser.
We didn't have much of an army there. Let's move
ja, Kaiser.
The BMW towards Hamburg. We have an army in Frankfurt. We need to protect Frankfurt too. Can't move anything from Amsterdam. North from Bristol. Alright. So we can't do anything there. End of turn report. We are minus 24,443. Alright. City grows. Frankfurt grows again. But we can't really upgrade it anymore. Can build a big CERN, a heavy tank factory, and the SPG training ground. Let's go for the heavy tank factory. And the town grows. Bristol has grown again. Go for a city in Bristol. We'll do that. Heroic death, Hansbush. He died. Battle of Stettin. We have an airport in Frankfurt. Good. Recruitment report. We have new BMW motorcycles moved to Hamburg. They were constructed in Frankfurt. We have Messerschmitt 109 fighters in Brussels, assault infantry in Copenhagen, and troopers in Oslo. Trooper ships. So, the following factions have declared that they are allies. The Spanish state has allied themselves to the United States of America. And the following factions have a ceasefire. The Italian Empire and the United States have made a ceasefire. Alright. And our country is very small. Now. Okay. Maybe have something to move from Copenhagen. We will move an assault infantry unit down towards Hamburg. Then in Berlin we will check the construction. One turn left until we have the airport in Berlin. See, it's not ready yet. And we have nothing else to construct this time. One turn left until the EU-88 is ready in Berlin. In Frankfurt we can now get the Mi-262 fighter jet. It has 52 missile attack, which is superior, and 46 defense. Very, very good. Only available from German cities when we have the airport built. So we soon have it available in Berlin as well. So we can see abilities at a glance. Special attack, bonus vs planes and vehicles, can swim, in essence can fly over water. Very long range missiles, frighten nearby enemy, excellent morale, can't hide, it's faster than other planes. Description, the Messerschmitt Mi-262, nicknamed Svalbe, German Swallow, in fighter versions, Sturmvogel, German Stormbird. In fighter-bomber versions, was the world's first operational jet-powered fighter aircraft. Design work started before World War II began, but problems with engines, metallurgy, and top-level interference kept the aircraft from operational status with the Luftwaffe until 1944. And we have now reached 1944, so it's correct to get them about this stage. Okay. And the Me-262 was faster and more heavily armed than any Allied fighter, including the British jet-powered Gloster Meteor. The difference is also that the Gloster Meteor, while it was completed and did see some action, it was never properly added into a unit with only Gloster Meteors. I believe there might have been one or two Gloster Meteors in the war, fighting side by side with other old planes, but there were no jet squadrons, while the Me-262 were used in actual jet squadrons, but not that many, unfortunately, for Germany, because they arrived too late, so they didn't get a lot of them out. Okay, one of the most advanced aviation designs in operational use during World War II, the Me-262's roles included light bomber, reconnaissance, and experimental night fighter versions. Alright. And yes, we want them as soon as possible. Let's start constructing them in Frankfurt immediately. Okay, and I believe we're done with that stuff now. What happens here? Britain took Istanbul as suspected. So Britain is now in control here. I have an area in the area of Eastern Europe. And the Soviets are about to attack Saloniki, held by the Italian Empire. They've taken back Belgrade from the rebels. And are also about to attack this area, Tirana, held by the Italian Empire. Italy is being pushed back by both Britain and Soviet. The Portuguese also have a unit here. Two riflemen and one Fire 3000 light tank. Vienna has once again revolted and is now under our control. Alright, let's destroy the barracks. Can and the farms if we can. No, we couldn't. Alright. So they are about to attack. We have a Spanish army outside of Bristol too. Alright, we'll click next turn. Union did attack Vienna, as suspected. The three units of planes, we will just auto-resolve this. Didn't attack anywhere else. Good. The Italian Empire took back Verona from the Soviet Union. And it's now a city. I don't know if it were, but I don't think so. It's been upgraded. Is once again under Italian rule. The area of Zagreb has revolted and is no longer controlled by the Soviet Union. Britain has a foothold here, as we saw in the last year or whatever, last turn. Novi Sad has revolted as well. The Soviets have problems with lots of revolts. Two areas have revolted. That's good, because that will prevent them from invading us. Okay, this unit of riflemen can be moved to Hamburg together with the BMW motorcycle and this unit of assault infantry. And we will move this plane unit inside the Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane inside of Stettin, because there are Soviet armies outside, one unit with just infantry and another one. Okay, settlement besieged Vienna. Yeah, they took Vienna. Settlement occupied. end of turn report, minus 66, that's better than before. Construction completed, we have an airport in Berlin. Recruitment report, we have a U-88, twin engine, multiple combat aircraft in Berlin. We also have one in Amsterdam and in Paris. And we have Messerschmitts in Stettin, Hamburg and Rouen. And diplomatic information, the following factions have broken their alliances. United States of America and the Spanish state. The following factions have declared that they are allies, the Spanish state and Portugal. The following factions have declared a ceasefire, the Italian Empire and the French Republic and the United States of America. Portugal and the French Republic. Alright. The Spanish state didn't attack. But the Soviets are about to attack Paris. So move an infantry unit to Rouen. And move this plane unit inside of Paris. So lots of planes in München. Okay. I believe we revolted. We got a lot of planes in the revolt too. We got a unit of Panzer IVs. We got 4 units of the U-88, and we got a lot of Messerschmitt 109s too, and a Stokes mortar unit. So they revolted with lots of good stuff against the Soviets. That's very good. That means we could move units to Frankfurt. Move the infantry from Frankfurt to München. I was pretty sure that they had taken that area. Let's move the planes to Frankfurt. How many planes? 1, 2, 3, 4. We can keep one. 3. Befehle Kaiser. Befehle Kaiser. Befehle Kaiser. Befehle Kaiser. We got a lot of Stukas. Moved up to Frankfurt. Frankfurt is a more important city. Here we have a large concern. The Howitzer training ground, maybe we had defended the city previously. I think it revolted, to be honest. Let's get a Howitzer training ground. And another U-88. Important to protect the city where we can get jets. So we need to wait 2 turns, I believe, or 3. Took forever. 3 turns. So it takes 4 turns to construct this plane. That's a long time. And we're dispressed or pressured. Alright, let's check the construction. In Berlin, we'll go for the SPG training ground now. It'll enable us to get the Hummel and such. Alright, nothing else to construct. In Berlin, 2 turns. 6 turns until we get that building. You can get the jets now. We'll do that. It will take 4 turns. Jets from Berlin as well. Troopers from Oslo. Messerschmitts from Hamburg. We are constructing the U-88 in München. And the ME-262 jet fighters in Frankfurt. EU-88 in Amsterdam, and Messerschmitt 109 fighters in Brussels. EU-88s in Paris, and Messerschmitt 109 fighters in Rouen. And instead we'll get the Messerschmitt 109 fighters as well. Assault infantry in Copenhagen, and we're back in Berlin. Actually, could speak to the British again in case more has changed on the map.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
Okay. Alright. Next turn. They are besieging München now. Some armies, but they didn't attack. Settlement besieged München by the Soviet Union. As we saw, their army, planes and infantry as usual. And that entire army, and their Igor Voroshilov again. Family member. Agent detected Spanish state. End of turn report, -4,833 profits. Construction report, we have an aerodrome in Rouen and in Stettin. We can get the U-88 from there now as well. Recruitment report, assault infantry in Copenhagen, trooper ships in Oslo. Diplomatic information, the following factions are now at war with each other. French Republic and the Portugal. The following factions have declared a ceasefire, the Italian Empire has declared peace with a ceasefire with French, the French Republic and the United States. Okay. They're still constructing the jet fighters. Two turns left in Frankfurt and three turns left in Berlin. The Soviet Union are preparing to attack Berlin. Huge forces. Sergei Ivanov. Outside, and two captains. They're also preparing to attack Stettin again, defended by Gunter Alterbrunn and his army. Okay, all the tanks, the Tiger ones, are fully sized. We do not have the best tanks yet. We can get Tiger 2s as well. And then we can get the Mustang from Berlin only, I believe, but we need better buildings for that. So we can get the Panzer IVs, Tiger Ones. Speedy training grounds. I'm surprised we can't construct the Tiger 2 here. We have the latest building, I'm pretty sure of that. We have a tank factory. That's weird. They should be able to have the Tiger 2 as well. It might be disabled in the recruitment. I made a mistake if that's the case. Because the Tiger 2 is supposed to be available. Maybe the fifth building or whatever is not really available to be constructed, so it might not be available. That's a problem. Then we can't get the mouse either. I will check that later when I exit the game. So it seems the mouse and the Tiger 2 can't be constructed in this mod, in this version. I added them to the final construction level, but that level might be deactivated from, because we have the heavy tank factory here. And I don't think there is a later one. It seems to be unavailable. Because we have the latest level of city as well. That means we are missing out on the two best tanks of the German Reich, but the Maus tank is only available from Berlin anyway. But the Tiger 2 that they used against the Western Allies, that tank should be available. So that's really bad that they are not available. Okay. Let's check the construction. We're still constructing the SPG training ground in Berlin. And other stuff in other areas. In Rauen, however, you can get a lot of stuff. Let's go for the medium tank factory. The medium tank factory allowed the Panzer IV and BMW motorcycles. The light one only allowed the Panzer I. That means that I should probably change stuff so that in the light one you get Panzer I's and 4's and then BMW motorcycles, and then in the medium one you get the Tiger I, and then in the heavy one you get the Tiger II's and the Mouse. Alright. Missed out on some buildings there in Stettin. We'll go for the Howitzer training ground. And we're back in Berlin. We are still constructing the ME-262 there. Alright. We are constructing and recruiting almost everywhere. In Copenhagen we'll get another assault infantry. And that's it. So the Soviet Union is sure to attack Munich the next time. Mostly defended by infantry. We will lose that battle, but I will still fight it, I guess. Oh, Britain has taken Saloniki from the Italians. And they've reached... They've taken an area from Bulgaria. They've reached the border with Greece, held by Italy. Let's move down this spy down here. Alright, so Italy is still in control of those areas. Two Spanish state armies here. Three units. They have some tanks. Panzer I tanks. Alright. Next time. They didn't attack the Soviet Union, they didn't attack. Alright. Spanish state might attack them. They didn't. Agent detected. Portugal. End of turn report, we are plus 723 in profits. Town grows, Hamburg, that's good. We can upgrade it to a city now, we'll do that. It will take 3 turns to upgrade the city. New family member, Hannes Becker. Construction complete, we have... Brussels has been... upgraded to a city. Good. We get the SS headquarters. The medium park. Farms plus 2. Asphalt roads. And that's it. Brussels actually. Right, and then we'll go for the aerodrome in Brussels. Construct a Smith-109 fighter there. Construction complete, yes. Recruitment report. We have Messerschmitts in Stettin, Brussels and Hamburg, as well as in Rouen. And we have UAJs in Paris and Amsterdam. And SMT infantry in Copenhagen. Diplomatic information. The British Commonwealth is now at war with the French state Vichy. And Italian Empire is still at peace with the USA and the French Republic. Construction completed. SS headquarters in Brussels. Medium Park in Brussels. Golf plus 2 in Bristol. And asphalt roads in Bristol. Alright. The Spanish state has an army here still. In Portuguese areas. Alright. Still held by Portugal, but they are allied now. The Soviet Union is still besieging München. So we will have a battle there soon. Probably next time. British Empire moving up armies here into Turkey. Alright. Luna Silvestre. The Italian Empire. Ah, we have a unit of planes here.
Kaiser! Kaiser!
Actually, this army could move some of the assault infantry back. I'm moving some planes.
Kaiser!
This one unit of planes in those armies. Protect the infantry.
Ja, mein Kaiser.
And this one also had a plane unit, good.
Befehle, Kaiser.
This one didn't. Okay.
Befehle, Kaiser.
If you have any riflemen here, we'll move them out. We didn't. So the infantry can move to Hamburg. Move a plane unit to this unit as well. Couldn't, they're surrounded by enemies. That sucked. So we moved out the unit, but can't move in anything.
Kaiser.
That sucked anyway.
Befehle, Kaiser. Befehle, Kaiser.
We moved in that unit then. And move Befehle, another Kaiser. Fighter plane unit to this army.
Ja, Kaiser. Befehle, Kaiser. Befehle, Kaiser.
Another assault infantry to Hamburg. And we move the BV motorcycle to this army. Good, so have some mechanized stuff in that army.
Ja, mein Kaiser.
Alright.
Kaiser! Befehle, Kaiser!
Alright, I think we're down there. Next turn.
Teilen die Einheiten des Reiches.
Shit, they attacked Berlin. Huge forces, it's very equal, the balance of power. Move the units just in time. Even Hitler himself is in the battle, but I believe they attack units outside. And I don't want the army of Hitler to be used by the AI. Other armies will be used by the AI. Let's place this under AI control, and we will not allow Adolf Hitler's army to be controlled by AI, because then Hitler will probably die. We'll retreat him, control the army ourselves. Okay, so the enemy we'll see in battle what they have. Let's start the battle. Battle be fought outside of Berlin, so it's not the Battle of Berlin. They attacked an army outside. So I moved those planes just in time. Unfortunately, our best army outside of Berlin was moved to Stettin. They had no choice.
Dieser Tag soll der Tag des Reiches werden. Auf in den Kampf! Ihnen nach, Männer! Für das Reich!
Mostly infantry here. Start deployment. No general, just officers. An officer here. Lots of infantry. This is the elite infantry army. The one that didn't get any planes because we couldn't move the planes to it. Or I just failed to click on it, maybe. But it has some elite of an SS infantry. The best infantry besides the snipers. The snipers are even better. But it's the best one out of the assault rifle units. We have the riflemen, we have the assault infantry, and then we have the North African infantry that are better than the ordinary assault infantry, but the SS is even better. Alright, and then we have snipers, the absolute best infantry unit. So they attack the weakest army, the one made up of only infantry. Let's group it and lose formation and AI control. Start the battle. We will, of course, attack the enemy, despite them having lots of tanks and whatnot. Reinforcements, yes, Captain Walter and the Führer himself. Alright, so the enemy has lots of tanks, MS-1 light tanks, T-34 medium tanks, lots of planes, as usual. The first army. Then they have another army over here, with more planes. And then have final third army, with lots of infantry and planes. Our army, consisting only of the infantry of all kinds, with the exception the North African infantry. We do not have that in the army. Then we have this army with lots of planes, but I will retreat that army to defend Berlin. That will give the enemy an advantage in the battle, but anyway, infantry and some planes. So one of the infantry armies aren't in the battle. This army might also have their BMW motorcycle. So most of the planes are under our control. Alright. Battle is started.
Hier unser Reich!
Didn't want the planes here to enter. Hopefully they won't. Our infantry army are charging the enemy. They will all be slaughtered by their planes, unfortunately. Infantry sucks. So the Führer himself is about to enter. Let's retreat immediately with the Führer. There is no model for him. We don't want him to die in the battle. He should fall in Berlin, nowhere else. Can't move in the infantry.
Unser General liegt tot auf dem Schlachtfeld. Ohne ihn könnten seine Männer den Mut und die Schlacht verlieren.
Plates. Alright, so we'll ruin everything if we can't fight the battle from within. He refuses to return. Alright, retreat. I'm not allowed to help. Yeah, I had 5B alone, that's why it didn't retreat. The game. Let's take control of all the planes. Just attack. Our planes are fighting in the air. Trying to retreat in the leader, but gets unselected immediately. Can't retreat or something. Okay, so we might die in the battle. Anyway. Our planes are fighting. They took out the first round of the infantry, so all the planes entered. Now it's a battle in the sky and all the bombers here. Big guys.
Ein Feind des Reiches liegt tot zu unseren Füßen.
In general fallen. Igor Vorofilov died. That's good news. Taken out quite a few of our big ship. Big planes. Underpowered. They're not superior to the airplanes, unlike the others. They have good attack strength and defense, but seem to be shot down easily, unlike the Portuguese ones. The Wellingtons, they were much better. Actually, I think it would have been better this battle if they had Messerschmitts rather than those big planes. Retreat. Big planes was a disappointment in the battle. They were a disappointment. Retreat. What the fuck is wrong with the unit? It never retreats. Some of them managed to exit, but not all of them. Yeah, finally it retreated. Good. We only have some planes left. This means that Berlin is very much undefended. Yeah, the big planes were let down. They were weaker than expected. thought they would be better than the Messerschmitts, but they were easier to shoot down for the enemy. If we had had only an army of like Messerschmitt 109 fighters, we would have probably won this battle, but instead we had a lot of the plain army with the big planes, and they were shot down. So we are losing balance of power, clearly on their side, 52% allies killed, 52% enemies killed. At least we got an epic battle. The big planes were a big letdown. Probably better to have Messerschmitts than to have them. Maybe we aren't as strong as I thought. Look at all the downed EU-88 bombers. We lost that army too.
Sammelt sie wieder, ehe der Sieg mit dem Wind davonfliegt.
So the Union won in the sky. Might have an ally still fighting. Yeah, they are still fighting over here. We had some BMW motorcycles. Mostly infantry. They are retreating. Of course they are. Yeah, the U-88 multiple combat aircraft, they were weaker than expected. Half the army were Messerschmitts. If I had another half with Messerschmitts, we could have probably won.
Die Feinde haben heute einen Sieg ergattert! Doch das Reich wird niemals besiegt werden.
Plain graveyard. Close defeat. Your army is Captain Sven and Captain Walter. Alright, men deployed 554, killed 553, men remaining 242, a clear defeat. Captain Walter, 757 men, 53 killed, 186 remaining. We had 3 armies too. But one retreated. Enemy armies, they had 4 armies invading, but one very small. Okay, Igor Voroshilov died, he had 410 men, down 722, very good. 207 remaining. Kirill Shrukov had 109 men, killed 83, 553 remaining. And Sergei Ivanov had 442 men. Alright, the Führer managed to leave the battlefield, so he probably survived. Unless they took him captive. We'll see. Return to the battle map. Okay. Would suck if the Führer had died. And then we won't have the Battle of Berlin. But still, I don't have the capital. Custom settlement. And the version with that city is not stable, unfortunately. Alright, so the Führer retreated back into Berlin. It's still held by an army. Alright, but the army in the north of Berlin is still not defeated. It's being attacked now by this army. It has the old Katyusha rocket trucks, and a unit of anti-aircraft trucks, and one unit of Yak-9s, and one unit of MiG-3s, and then a lot of infantry. No general. Then we have Kirill Shurkov. Planes and infantry. Alright. And we have only infantry in this army. Assault infantry. And then we have one unit of EU-88. We will certainly lose, but I'm still gonna fight that battle in real time. Alright. Fight the battle on the battle map. Well, the Führer is in trouble. Lost all his planes pretty much in the battle. Alright. We'll need to move the army from Stettin to reinforce Berlin.
This
infantry army won't survive even if that plane unit. These planes were a big letdown. They spent all that time constructing these planes just for them to underperform in battle. They're supposed to be better than the Messerschmitt 109 fighters, but still did poorly. They are easier to shoot down. That's why they didn't do as well. They have better defense and better attack, but somehow their health is less. So they were easier to shoot down. Okay, let's group them. Lose formation. And we will place them under AI control. Start the battle, pass the game. We will attack their planes, obviously. So, and the battle has started. Enemy has rocket trucks. The old projectile. Entire infantry army over here. Stretching all this way. Entire line here. Trying to defend Berlin. The best army with planes and tanks. The second best army, the one for the best of the armies outside of the city, had to be moved to Stettin. So we lose that instead of Berlin. We'll move that army back to Berlin. The Soviet has defeated all the armies outside of Berlin and the army inside. And only very few survived. This plane unit won't be able to survive this battle, I'm pretty sure about that.
Hear unser Reich!
Und vielleicht unsere Chance auf Sieg gleich mit.
And another one. Fuck.
Diese Niederlage drückt auf die Herzen aller, die das Reich ihre Heimat nennen.
That's good. Our army. Alright, so all the armies outside of Berlin have been defeated. Clear defeat. Captain Sven had 776 men. Killed 31 of the enemy. 44 remaining. Captain Alexander had 457, killed 222, have 428 remaining. Kirishuk have 495, killed 510, very good of him. 495 remaining. Then we have the detailed battle statistics. And return to the map. Yeah, the U88s were a big letdown. Not worth the money they were that were spent. But they didn't attack Berlin yet. Good. Alright, but Berlin is in big trouble. It's surrounded by enemies. Very few planes left. A lot of infantry retreated to the city as well. We'll merge them. Final battle. Alright. These are all that remains. Berlin is in big trouble. Very big trouble. They have lots of armies there. Actually, we have no choice, but we will leave one unit of. We won't leave anything there. This army will reinforce Berlin under Gunter Alterbung. This plane, this army will move to Stettin to defend. We have two units of SLD that can move to Hamburg. Ah, we have the jet fighters finally. But will they be able to aid Berlin? Is the question. They will be added to the Battle of Berlin for sure. Just in time. Because the U88's disappointed. Big deal. Okay, we don't need to move the infantry. All of these could also be moved.
Führe die Armeen zusammen, Kaiser.
Berlin capital. An army inside of München being besieged. Frankfurt, we need to move stuff to Frankfurt. Five units could have been moved here. Leave the Stukas in Amsterdam. We won't reach with the infantry there. We don't need those infantry units. Frankfurt, we need at least one in Frankfurt. Actually, we could. How many turns left? One. What building is that? Airport. U88. Actually, Frankfurt is more important. See you soon. I need to go do. Alright, Mr. Nigren here. I'm back. It's time to defend Berlin, probably. It's been besieged. Faction destroyed. The French state Vichy has been destroyed. End of turn report. We are minus 8,053 in profits. Unit recruitment completed. We have the ME-262 jet fighter. Move to Berlin to defend Berlin. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. India and the Japanese Empire. Alright, and the following factions have declared a ceasefire, same as before, Italian Empire and the French state, French Republic, I mean, and the United States. The Soviet Union are still besieging München, an area that they believe revolted to us. That's why we have such bad troops there. I didn't have any Panzer IVs or Stukas or mortars, so I believe it's a revolt unit. We moved a lot of U-88s and other stuff from there. We have an army here too, of planes. The U-88s underperformed in battle. If we look at the statistics, we can see that the Stukas have 27 missile attack and 18 total defense. And the Messerschmitt 109 fighters have 33 missile attack and 29 total defense at experience 1. Yeah. Okay, and then we have the U-88, they have better missile attack at 38 compared to 33 and 27 defense, while these guys have 29. They have too low defense. I believe they should have more defense because they are too easily shot down compared to the other planes. That's why the Wellington guy and Portuguese planes are really good, because they have a very high defense, but these guys have the same attack but worse defense, and that makes them so easy to shoot down, so they can't do shit. They were a big letdown. But the jet fighters, they are something else entirely. We only have one unit, so if they take Berlin, we lose our second area where we can construct those planes. I believe now we are ready to construct them in Berlin, but unfortunately we are besieged, so any construction will be halted until the siege stops. However, we have Frankfurt where we can get them. We will immediately construct another one. But I don't have much of an army there anymore. So actually, we will do this. Let's see here. We will move the entire armada of planes to Frankfurt. It's a more important city. And we will move George Becker to Frankfurt as well. And this U-88 will be moved there too. Then we have only infantry there. We move another unit of Messerschmitts to that place. And another one will be moved to Paris. We need one in Paris at least. The infantry can stay in Paris. And move these three to Paris. Leave at least one plane there. So we have room for one more in Frankfurt. We'll move one of them to Frankfurt. Five infantry units. We can't move them. Not all of them at least. Another one can be moved to Frankfurt. I don't need infantry.
Befehle Kaiser. Ja. Befehle Kaiser. Ja. Kaiser.
One in each of those cities is okay. Frankfurt is very important. Because we can get the jets there. We can't get them from Paris or Brussels. They are not German cities. They don't have the latest upgrade either. Only Berlin and Frankfurt has that. The war is lost if we lose Frankfurt. Okay. But we need one plane in Brussels. One in Paris and one in Rouen. Alright, we could the general could be moved to Amsterdam actually. Here we have a Stuka bomber plane. So we moved some infantry to Stettin and one plane. We are out of regions. We can't move anything from Minchen. So most of this army is locked there. Move to the army there. We need a full army outside of Berlin. I believe that these planes can't be moved. They can't reach the army at least. We don't want to move a rifleman unit. Well, we could move one unit of riflemen there. For now. Okay, we're done. Let's check the construction. 3 turns left until we have the SPG training ground in Berlin. And the construction is halted at the moment. Alright, nothing to construct. 1 turn left until we have the ME-262 in Berlin, but it's halted at the moment. Sucks. Okay. Troopers in Oslo, let's go for that. And in Hamburg we'll get another Messerschmitt 109 fighter plane. And in Amsterdam, I believe the Messerschmitts did well. They were better than the U88. I will go for the Messerschmitts. Look at their stats, they have better defense. 31 at experience 2. U88 have only 27, they have far too low defense. Unfortunately we won't be able to get the Mouse tanks and the Tiger 2s because of a mistake in the recruitment where I thought they had another building after the heavy tank factory, but they didn't, so unfortunately we can't get their 2 best tanks. The Tiger 1 is the best tank we can get. Okay, we will go for the Messerschmitts in Paris and in Rouen. And in Stettin, Assault Infantry Copenhagen, as usual. We're back in Berlin. Alright. At least this plane could be moved. Agents could be moved. Soviet Union has taken Athens, the capital of Greece. I thought it would be taken by Britain, but it was taken by the Soviets. Okay. Vienna's revolted once again to the Reich. Actually, they can't reach Berlin. They could actually attack the Portuguese. Let's do that. They will reinforce the city. So now we got some reinforcements in this city. That's good. Vienna will be lost anyway. We will destroy this building again. Pretty sure they will win. So this is a city. Actually, we destroy everything in it. What do we have? Yeah, we will lose big time. Let's just destroy everything here. Lost. shame, but I don't want the Soviets to have this stuff. Alright, we destroyed most of the buildings in München. It's not as valuable anymore. Alright, let's click next turn. We do not want to become a protectorate of the Soviet Union, sorry. So they attacked and they are allied with Portugal. Portuguese have 1 unit of riflemen and 1 unit of 5,000 light tanks, Italian light tanks. Soviet Union, we have that unit of... So they have 2 units of riflemen and 6 units of assault infantry. 1 unit of React 9 fighters and 5 units of MiG-3 fighters. They also have a lot of rams. Alright, and... yeah, the Battle of München starts. I destroyed the buildings just in time. Let's save the game. The Allied army will be air control. Fight the battle on the battle map. Alright, start deployment. We have mortars here too. Let's place them in loose formation. Fire at will. And we have some infantry. And the tanks could be moved to the plaza of the city in loose formation and guard mode. Doesn't really matter. Loose formation for the planes as well. Stand there and defend. So the Portuguese here with their ram, their car, 2 units of fights, just a remnant force there. And the Soviet Union, real danger, lots of planes as usual, infantry, lots of these vehicles, there are these car rams. Their infantry now. Assault infantry mostly. And their planes. Oh, here's our glitch. The wall has ended up in the air because of this hill. We need to move around that area. Stokes mortar should be firing. They have been fired at by the plane. Our infantry reinforcements have arrived here. The planes of the Soviet Union are upon them. Far too close. I believe they will be broken before they reach the city. So they won't be able to reinforce the city. They moved in from area from which they revolted the Vienne. Both of these armies are revolting troops. Their number is enough for us to fight the battle. Still they will be slaughtered by their plague. They are already losing. Probably lose tanks and started to fire one. Our general died, the captain. We will still have our tanks and a few Stukas in the air. Done, that's the final Stuka planes. All tanks are now done as well. We only have the infantry left. All the important buildings, at least. for 36 minutes, so this battle is over. Total air superiority. Even their infantry has reached the center now. They are fighting our infantry, believe. So. They won the Battle of München. I might have returned to the map too soon. So it might crash. Oh, it didn't crash good. Vienna is attacked. Let's just auto-resolve that one. Now another one is attacked. They attacked the army outside of Berlin. They have 6 units of fighter planes, MiG-3 fighters. 3 assault infantry. Should be able to defeat that one. Then they have this force too. We should be able to win this. We'll fight the battle on the battlefield. Felix battle and his army. Alright. Fight battle on the battle map. So this army has the jet fighters.
Für die Ehre, für das Reich. Die Feinde des Reiches werden nicht entkommen.
Start deployment. Loss of the U-88 fighters too, or multiple combat aircraft. Stukas too, that are from the revolting army. Here are the jets, the Mi-262 jet fighters. Alright, lose formation and we'll group them. Guard mode. We don't really need guard mode. Okay, and let's just place them under AI control. I won't do anything else. And start the battle. And order them to attack. See how this will go. Lots of trees, that's not good. Power is evenly matched. Percentage allies get 8%, enemies get 6%. Problem with the U-88s are not only that they have low defense values, but they are also very bad in the sense they have very short range. They need to be close to the enemy to kill them. So they will be shot down before they reach the enemy due to their low defense. Okay, infantry's retreating. Taking out some of their rocket tracks, but not all of them. Nice to see our jets in action. For the first time in this campaign. Big planes are just a big letdown. Enemy General Fallen Captain Alexander.
Ein Feind des Reiches liegt tot zu unseren Füßen.
We are winning. This bad. Yet they have the same speed as the spaceships, the TIE fighters, and the X-Wings of Star Wars 2 or Alexander. They are similar as two spaceships in speed, faster than the other planes of this model. Captain Nikita has fallen. A Soviet captain. Yeah, we have won the battle. 62%, 63% enemies killed, 21% allies. They fled. Alright, what is the statistic? We can continue the battle. General, he's still alive, Felix. All right, so they fled. The remainder of their troops there. Somewhere. Yeah. Assault the infantry, they're retreating. Alright, let's fast forward. Took out some of their troops. Clear victory! Alright. So Felix Battle had 501 men, killed 424, very good, 432 remaining. And Captain Nikita had 265 men, killed 74, and 112 remaining. Some of our, one unit of ours were riflemen, we lost most of those. Okay, Captain Alexander had 387 men. Killed 979. Alright, detailed statistics. And back to the attacked immediately again. The same army was attacked by Piotr Bychtov, a new general of the Soviet Union. It's mostly infantry, some old tanks, MS-1 tanks, and some planes. Still had a few planes, but we will win this too, I believe. We have the upper hand. We will save